Amen. So we shall continue where we left last week in this series, I hope that God Almighty will continue to help us as we go through this series in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The ways of ants. The ways of ants. So this is going to be part two. The ways of ants. You want to consider the ways of ants. So fats are friends. You know, when you get fats, they are very important to us. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6 says, go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider our ways and be wise. Solomon speaking here. And we should go to ants. Consider our ways so that we can be wise. This is not only for sluggard or slothful person or complacent person. It's for everybody. When you see something that is good, it's good to take a very good example of that and apply this to our life. Say, which have you no captain, overseer or ruler, provides our supplies in the summer and gathers our food in harvest? See, wisdom is so important that there is nothing we can do. We cannot just ignore wisdom. If we are wise, we cannot ignore wisdom. Proverbs chapter 1 verse 7 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction. All these qualities of hands, we cannot despise it. We cannot say, oh, it's just another animal. Just three pairs of legs, small creature. What can we? No. We just have to see the qualities that God placed in these little animals, this little creation, and see what we can learn from this and see what we can apply into our lives. Even organizations are doing this. Organizations, business gurus, they want to see why is that ants are very successful in all that they do. So they look into all these qualities. And so Christians also must do this. Look into the qualities that are in the life of ants and see how we can apply this into our lives. We must love wisdom. Wisdom is so important. You must love it. Proverbs 4 from verse 6 explains this way. Do not forsake her, and she will preserve you. Wisdom has sense of preservative. Don't forsake wisdom. All this instruction I'm giving you, jot them down. Go back and listen to these messages and see how you can apply this into your life. Do not forsake wisdom. It will preserve your life. It will preserve you. It will help you. And it says, love her, and she will keep you. If wisdom will help you in the time of storm. You can remember all these informations and apply this at the time of storm and see how we will come out of this. So love her, and she will keep you. Wisdom is the principal thing. Something that is not primary, per se. It's more than primary. It's not secondary, per se. It's so important. It's a principal thing. It's a partner in life. Wisdom. It's a principal partner in life. So you cannot ignore wisdom. And all you're getting, get understanding. So if you can get wisdom, that is good. In all you're getting, get understanding. So please, as we peruse into this, the ways of ants, be attentive. Try as much as possible to see personally what can I gain in this life of this creation. Look at the facts about ants. Ants are very active. They are very active. Two, persistent. They are very persistent. Three, perseverance. They can endure. You never see ants starting on a task and leaving that task and go somewhere else. Or being on a road, maybe they are pushing something and they're in a queue and see them be disorganized. No. They endure. They stand the test of time. Diligent. They are very diligent. They are very serious in what they do. They are very disciplined. And that's what we are learning about them today. We've had about so many champions in life. And I have never seen any champion who is not disciplined. I have never seen one. If you have seen one, let me know. Either in athletic, either in business, anything. They are very serious and they are very disciplined in all that they do. Very energetic, very hardworking, very industrious. They have a lively behavior. and ants are very careful and they manage their resources very well. You can imagine in summer they will gather all that they will eat in winter. And they will not go there and eat everything up before winter. They will manage the resources throughout winter, throughout the period that they cannot go out to get food. Some of us, we cannot even keep food that we are going to eat in the night. Keep it in the morning. Some people, they keep going there. They keep going there. Before the night comes, the food will disappear. But you can see this little creation. They will keep the food that we eat for the whole winter, and they will spread everything. Is that not amazing? That's amazing. The Bible says, in Proverbs chapter 30, Proverbs 24, it says, there are four things which are little on the heart, but they are extremely wise. Four things. The ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their food in their season. They prepare their food in the summer. They are not that very strong per se when you talk of energy. But you know that ants, according to what I read about ants, it's been proven that ants can carry a weight three times. An ant can carry a weight three times its own weight. Three times its own weight. And they will endure and continue to move very patient. They are very persistent. They will move until they get to their destination. And they share things among themselves. They share things among themselves. Is that not awesome? They work in team, teamwork. They work in team. They look out for each other's welfare. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So, let me ask you a question. What is persistence? Because we started last week to explain things about that, and I want us to just go into the introduction or into some what I can call definitions. What is persistence? I put it here, continue steadfastly, constantly. Persistence. You continue steadfastly and constantly. Let me say something very carefully. I told you last week that slow and steady wins the race, right? To be slow is not a problem. Anybody can slow down. But to be steady is hard. The challenge that all of us have is to be steady. In order to lay your hands upon that, you are steady. You continuously do that thing. You engage in that thing, not being tired. You continue to endure looking for harvest. That you are patient, steady, to be steady. Even as a Christian, God wants you to be steady. God wants you to be steadfast, unmovable. In your faith, God wants you to be constant. Revelation 3 explains that to us. God does not want you, one of the structures there, he doesn't want you to be hot today, cold tomorrow, lukewarm. No. God wants you to take a stand and stand on that principle. For anybody to succeed in life, even as a family, you must be steady. You are not going to blow cold today, blow warm tomorrow, blow hot now. No, God wants you to be what?
Steady.
Continue steadfastly, constantly. Firm or obstinate, continuous in a course or action in spite of difficulty or opposition, you continue to persevere. And to be steadfast. That is persistent. Despite all the pressure, despite all the opposition, but that you stand your ground, you continue to endure the race. There is no straight line to success. Many people, they want church court. They just want it anyhow. No. You got to fulfill some righteousness. You got to pass through some difficulties. You got to carry this cross to get to a place of resurrection. Amen.
Amen.
Persistence. Now, let's look at persevere. Because one of those qualities of heart. So we can explain persistence and persevere together. Persevere to understand that you can break it into two. The previous, we can say par. Par means true. And severe. So persevere. True, that you pass through that severe occasion, tough times, you continue to pass through it without shaking. Can I put it this way? True, coupled with the word severe, it means to keep pressing on, trusting. keeping guard, looking up, doing our duty, even through severe circumstances, you are very resilient despite all the odds. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58. Therefore, 1 Corinthians 15, 58. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord, you are steadfast on that course. It is a business. As long as you set your goal, that you are steadfast, you persist. Even when it is very hard, you continue to press on. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord be favored in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God has his own part to play, but you have yours to play. That you lay your hands on something, even if it's a ministry, if it's Christianity, you lay your hands on it and say, I will never go back from serving God. Come what may, come sunshine, come painful, I will stand in this my faith. I will not go back. I continue to press on towards the mark.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the key there is to be steady. Tell somebody, be steady.
Be steady.
Even if it's relationship, if you are in a relationship, you have to be steady. If you have a friend that is not steady in his relationship, there will be a problem. If you're a business person, you are not steady, there will be a problem. That's why they say punctuality is sort of business. That you are always punctual, you are steady. You are, whatever is coming, any way, anything, you are steady. If you are not steady, if you cannot take risk, you cannot do business. So, when it's very troublesome, you are still standing. When it's plenty, you are still standing. Paul said, I have learned to live in plenty and also to live in scarcity. You are steady, consistent, faithful, regardless of whatever is coming your way. Look at Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison tried 10,000 ways to make just a light bulb. Can you understand that? 10,000 ways before he eventually broke it up, before he eventually got it right. 10,000 ways making, well, you know, right now they say, go buy me bulb. And we have many types now. Buy me the economical one, the one I can use for 5 years. Buy me the one I can use. You never remember that somebody, the person who invented this, worked so hard, did not give up. If some of us, after you have tried 100 times, say, forget about this, or just forget. Maybe you try 1,000 times, okay, I've tried my best. I'm telling you the truth. 10,000 times is not easy. 10,000. Some people say, where is God? By then you do like 2,000, God, where is your face? Where are you standing? Where are you, God? Where are you? Where? We'll continue to query God. Some of us want some God to do something in our lives. Can we wait for God to do it? Some are not patient. One of the problems we have as human beings, we are not patient. Some of us, we are not patient. Let me say the truth very carefully. If you are not patient, you are not going to get quality things. You are not going to get quality things. Either you want to buy a house, God will be patient. Because if you fall to the hands of this realtor, they will push you. Say, why, what are you looking for? Just buy this one. Want to buy a car, you have to be patient. If not, the car dealers, as soon as you walk in, they will tell you, this is the best. Let me tell you, this car is the best. They have used it in Japan, they use it in London, they use it in Canada, they use it in, if this car can go in the summer, it can go in winter, it will talk and talk. But find your way out of that place. Get another dealer. The one will tell you, you see this car is being used in the moon. This car, you can take it to the space. Find your way, get out of that one, get another dealer. Oh, this one, it doesn't use gas at all. Put water, it will move. Because they don't want to sell.
Absolutely.
So if you are the type that cannot be patient enough to look around, to work hard and do all your calculations and depend on prayers and pray to God, they will give you just anything. I tell you the truth, if it's his car, as we are driving it out of that place, if it is brand new, the dealer, when I bought a car, brand new, the dealer told me, say, Emmanuel, I will be very honest with you. He discovered that I'm a pastor. Look at everything very well now. When you drive out of this place outside there, You are bringing it back. He told me the percentage that has gone. He said, that's, he told me that 10%, 10% or 20%. It's now pre-hold. He told me that. That beat my heart. He said, okay. I said, I look. I respected the reality, he told me. That is the what? The reality of life. And he told me. So we have to be patient. We have to know what we are doing. So in this message, steady, persistent, and resilient, very important. So in this part two, even Jesus Christ explained to us, and I want to explain this because of time, and we are going to go this afternoon, then we'll go to part three. There's something that Jesus explained to us. He gave us a parable on persistence. And that parable is so strong that even in prayer, people are visiting it. Those of you that have been asking God for something, let me tell you something. God is hearing you.
Amen.
When you pray to God to do something in your life, God can give you at least three, you can have three results. God can say wait, God can say no, and God can say yes. Even when you get any of this, the resultant effect, the manifestation might not be just now. Even when God says yes, God can say yes, and the manifestation may come in 10 years' time. And he said yes, he prayed God and said yes, but the manifestation for that prayer he answered may not come until 10 years, may not come until 2 days, may not come until 5 days. So that is why if you are very doubtful, you cannot get anything from God. Because after you have done the will of God, there's a need of patience to receive God's promise. Husband and wife, we must learn in this. Do not rely on automatic. You know, some of us, you know, we have those of us that learn how to drive with stick, we have an advantage over people that are automatic. They just taught them how to drive. Give them stick. Those who were taught how to use automatic, give them stick. You see how to teach them how to put it to reverse, how to put it into brake, how to put it into first gear, second gear, third gear. But if you learn how to use all those stick, and you are giving automatic, it's a piece of cake. Amen.
Amen.
It's what?
Piece of cake.
So God is preparing you to be able to crack goals. He's preparing you to be able to do excellent things. He's preparing you to be able to launch into the deep ocean to go and catch waves. Salmon, big one. Not staying on the river shore and be catching all those small fish. All those small fish that cannot even feed you, let alone to feed your family. God is preparing you to be able to stand, even in the evil days. Luke chapter 18, the parable of the persistent widow. Then he spoke a parable to them that men always ought to pray and not lose heart. Say, there was a certain city, a judge, who did not fear God, nor regard man. Now there was a widow in that city, and she came to him, saying, get justice for me from my adversary. And he would not for a while, but afterward he said within himself, though I do not fear God nor regard man, yet because this woman troubles me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. She was persistent, resilient. She kept coming, and this man said, come on, I have to answer this woman. This woman will kill me if I don't answer her. We need to be very persistent. We need to be very resilient. We need to be steady. You stand on your ground, you are steady. The Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said. And shall God not avenge his own elect who cry out day and night to him, though he bears long with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he really find faith on the earth? Jesus comes today. We need to find people that are going to be steadfast. We need to find a steady Christian. Not one today, call tomorrow. Some of us, we say we are born again. Today we are hard for God, tomorrow we are cold. You are active today for God, tomorrow you are not active. Some of us, we say we are born again. But we are worse, our life is worse than unbelievers. If any man be in Christ, should be a new creation. All this must pass away, all this must be new. When you give your life to Christ, there must be a different And it's not going to be different to have a difference today and tomorrow the difference is gone. And next week the difference is back. You must be steady. You must be steadfast. You must be unmovable. You know, the issue of being steady in life is so important that even sport people, they begin to study why is it that some people, some teams, we have a big setback and then they will bounce back. I don't know, let me use this example and we're going to pray. I don't know if you watched the Super Bowl last week, Sunday. In the history of Super Bowl, the New England Patriots took them to extra time. It is. When I was watching this, one of our fathers in the church here was calling me, we were discussing, he was watching it on in his own house, I was watching it in my house, and we were discussing. At the point we said that is it, that the Falcons, the Atlanta Falcons, they got it. 23. What will you are they going to perform? 23, down, 25 points, down, what will happen? But you see, Tom Brady and the coach, I was watching, you know some coach, they will stand up, they will do like this. But that coach was cool. Tom Brady, the quarterback, was cool. And like a joke, like a play, they went and got 25 points without any answer from the Falcons, the Atlanta Falcons. I was surprised. And they pushed them into what? Extra time. In the history of that game. And eventually, they won by 34-28. What happened? I begin to think, what happened? They were very steady. See, it's not an issue of rushing. If you want to speed, speed. But the people said, the English people said, the slow and steady wins the race. If you can be steady when you are moving very fast, okay. But the key is that you must what? You must be steady. If you want to accelerate fast, it's okay. But you must be what?
Steady.
You must push at a particular speed. You must not drop the quality. And that's how they won it. They were keeping, they were steady. The Falcons, they just come. And then at the point of time, they begin to melt. They begin to what?
Melt.
They begin to melt. And the teamwork. He was the best quarterback. The first one that would win 5 Super Bowls. 5. But it was a teamwork. Hello? It was what?
Teamwork.
It was a teamwork because, you know, according to the news, see, there was a circus cast by Julian Edelman. That cash was makes a difference and destroyed the whole plan of Atlanta Falcons. Do you remember the Cavaliers and the Desert Warriors? You remember them in the NBA? You watch sport. If you don't watch sport, look at all this record breaking and see how we can apply this to our lives. They have to pay the one the best 4 out of those out of that 7. And the Desert Warrior in that NBA already had what? 3. And the Cavaliers, LeBron James team, he had only what? 1. And if they are going to win, then they need to win the remaining 3. Do you think that is easy? In the final, to win 3 as in a row was not easy. But they break that record. Because they were what? Persistent. They were what?
Steady.
And they were what?
Teamwork.
Teamwork.
Thank you, teamwork. If it's only LeBron James carrying the whole ball among all his team, can they win?
No.
Teamwork. So, hands, they give us that. They work together, they cooperate among themselves. Everybody is very disciplined. They have no captain, there is no leader among them, but everyone knows what to do. And everyone does it, and does it well. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The ways of hands. We can succeed. We can make it. Do not give up. Be persistent. In anything you lay hands upon, tell the enemy, you cannot stop me. Satan, you cannot stop me. This one I must break through. If it's education, do not give up. Do not do what?
Yeah.
But be steady. Don't do what you're supposed to do now and go and sleep. Be steady. If it is business, do not what?
Give up.
Do not give up. Be what?
Steady.
If you are carrying an experiment, do not do what?
Give up.
Do not give up. Be steady. Be unmovable. Be abounding. Be stronger than whatever challenge you are having. You will surprise the enemies.
Amen.
Even in this land, the Lord will favor you.
Amen.
Be steady with God. Let your service to God be steady. Don't be lukewarm. Today you are hot, tomorrow you are cold. God does not want that. He said, I will do what? Speak you out of my mouth. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May He bless your week. As you go this week, may He prosper you.
Amen.
Know that you lay your hands upon the all your desire come to pass in Jesus' name.
Amen.
On this one, you will not be tired.
Amen.
On this one, you will not be weary.
Amen.
You will not give up.
Amen.
You will not come back at the edge of victory.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we bless you this afternoon,
Amen.
Because you're a good God. We thank you for this opportunity and the privilege that we have to come together as your children to start the week in your house. As we go out, Father, may your blessings remain with us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you help us, oh Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And prosper every work of our hands.